गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी. आई आकांक्षा श्रीवास्तव, मैनेजर एट एयरक्रू एविएशन प्राइवेट लिमिटेड, इज हेयर टू टेल यू अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ लिंक्डइन फॉर मैनेजमेंट प्रोफेशनल एंड एमबीएस. सो अ लॉट ऑफ एमबीए स्टूडेंट एंड ग्रेजुएट ऑफन वंडर दैट वाई दे हैव टू अपडेट देयर लिंक्डइन प्रोफाइल, वॉट विल दे गेट अबाउट इट, एंड इवन इफ दे प्लान टू दे just keep on postponing it and it goes to their never gonna do list. So like other unlike Facebook, Instagram that we keep updating every day in our lives, LinkedIn doesn't give us the experience of relationship building, the emotional connect or shared memories. Then why do you go about LinkedIn? Why do you have a LinkedIn profile? Why do you think that it is important, and why the industry thinks it is important? The main thing is it enables networking, but without the facilitating meaningful relationships. So why do you have to update your LinkedIn profile? I have taken five important reasons about it. The first one is it is a great platform for connecting with the professionals. So it is very important for all the professionals to network with the people in their industry, outside the industry, carry their relationships in person, and like you meet somebody on an event and then you have to ask about that industry or want to work in that industry for that matter in coming 2 to 5 years, then you should go and ask them. You have to The best way to know about things about industry is to interact with people of similar thought process. So LinkedIn is a great platform to connect with all those people from whom you can share your knowledge, get their knowledge, get important insights and opinions about job openings and the industry as it's working as a whole. The next reason would be it is an ultimate personal branding platform. We have all heard that we have to brand ourselves, we have to sell ourselves at our interviews, we have to perceive the best part of ourselves. So LinkedIn pages is the best platform to promote ourselves as a professional. So nobody's gonna know care that you have a dog or that you went to somewhere and check out your Insta. They won't. They will see where you have worked, what all accomplishments you have had, and how other people, other professionals feel about your work culture. So they will focus upon that. So you should have your LinkedIn profile and ask your connects, ask your peers and your mentors, mentees to give recommendations and comments on your post, so that there will be a nice and recommendable and respected posts. So that is one thing. And LinkedIn profiles, LinkedIn provides us all the types of media. So you can upload images, videos, summary. Even if you want to tell about your dog, that also many great stories about our personal lives can affect our professional culture. So you can even do that, and that will help the interviewer or the other company understand you as a person and how your personal life and professional life interacts with each other. That will give you a stand in their company if they deem you fit about it. So yes, the next part is it is the best place to get hired. LinkedIn helps many of the premium companies to recruit people. Go through your LinkedIn profiles first and foremost, search you on LinkedIn and then get you towards your interview. So it's better to give your best foot forward. The one thing you have always heard is that show your the first perception is the best perception. So that only the first perception is always your LinkedIn profile. So you have, should maintain it nicely. So, and there are many job openings, the LinkedIn jobs, so you can turn on the notifications and it will just pop up and you can apply through LinkedIn, easy apply even. And if not, then the website, it takes you to the website and you can apply that as well. So hiring managers use LinkedIn to find the ideal candidates and you could be one. The next is, it helps you remain on the top of what's happening in the industry. So LinkedIn, as we have seen, it is a interface where every industry professionals give their insights and give their accomplishments, everything. So they publish their what findings, they write blogs, they tell you about their lives, what is happening in their personal life as well and in professional life as well. So you get a lot of case studies, you get a lot of insights than what happening in industry, which company has acquired which, and all the mergers and acquisitions if they have happened. Also the news sections, and there are blogs, there are communities that talk about it. So you can keep engaging in LinkedIn and can get all the insights and much awaited insight without the media interference. So it is not filtered by media and there is nothing dramatic die about it. So you will have to just read it and it will be plain and simple, all important insights. And that will give you the clearest view about the industry that you are aiming for. The next one is, it is a great way of being found on Google. So we have seen movies. So in movies, if anybody has to find you on Google, then they go to Google and just type your name. We have all tried at some point of our time that we will Google our name and nothing pops up really. But if you have an active LinkedIn profile, it is the best way to get there. You will be found on LinkedIn no matter what. It will go through that, and LinkedIn follows a 7 contact list. So there also there is a first connection, second connection, third connection. So it goes on like that, and it's high chances that you will be found. If not, then your company, your work profile, that could be added to the search and you will be found. And that it is so that is an excellent way for the recruiters to look up you, and even your friends, your colleagues, you can look up your mentors. If you have met somebody, it will be the easiest way to find someone. You can't find somebody on Instagram for that matter like that. So like Gibby Graves once said, that LinkedIn profile gives you an opportunity to say what you are, what you do, and why you do what you do. That is the most important thing for the recruiters, because they want to understand you, who you are as a person, and what would you do to benefit the company. And why will you do what you do? Because what's your motive behind it? It is what drives you towards it. So it will enhance you. It will make you understand yourself and the recruiter to understand you as well. So how do you go about making LinkedIn profile an asset? So there are 6 steps about it. I have taken 6 steps about it. So first is revise your profile in light of your MBA application. Second, present your best and most authentic self, contextualize your achievements, work on the network, follow your preferred school, alumni, industry, and everything. Don't get reckless in your quest for a stronger presence. We as a management professionals or MBA students, go about LinkedIn and try to make connections and get the most out of it. But sometimes it doesn't work. So how do you go about it? How much should you comment? How much should you not? What type of post you should write? And let's see how we go about that. So first is revise your profile in light of your MBA application. We have written our MBA applications, everybody. And we have gone, why we want to do an MBA and what drives us, what are our strengths, what are our weaknesses. We don't have to give our resume there. We don't have to provide our resume on our LinkedIn profile. It just have to be a plain, simple who we are. So if we are hardworking, just write hardworking. A little sense why you are hardworking, what you have done that makes you hardworking. it doesn't mean that you have to give a resume that hardworking, skills hardworking. Like, we don't have to do that. It's just for your consistency. Your MBA application is the best version of yourself. And similarly, your LinkedIn profile shows us that. So you have to update your profile with that and access your capabilities and just keep it consistent throughout. The next thing is present your best and most authentic self. You don't have to lie, because on LinkedIn profile, your connections can connect you with what skills you have. They can endorse you. Your mentors can endorse you. So you don't have to lie there, and you can tell anything that is I have gone through an accident. So I would be writing about my accident, that how I recovered from an accident. That shows my recruiter that I am true to myself and why I have had that gap in my professional career. So that is, you don't have to lie that I was just sitting on the bed. You had an accident, that's life, and that should be shown. So use your summary to provide a concise overview of the career path you are. And don't forget to demonstrate your volunteer work, hobbies, interests, and give a more well-rounded view of who you are and what you care about. The next would be contextualize your achievements. We often indulge in various activities, and then we do that, and then we forget about it. I was having a difficulty in, walking my dog, for example, when he was, it was small, it was a puppy. But now he walks beside me. So that was a tough time. And now I have achieved that. But we forget about it. So you should remember your achievements like that. That was a personal experience. But in professional life as well, we do a project. And then we struggle about it. And then in some way, we always go through it and get out of it. But we forget about that. Just remember that. Recognize yourself, that what you have achieved, what you have grown through with doing that project, and just mention that in your posts, how you have done that project, what happened, and means not the base important details, keep that to yourself, just your learnings, so that other people can know you better, and even your juniors can learn from you. There will be many following you and many learning from you, from your experiences, and just keep it concise. It's not a essay writing competition. The next one is work the network. Be sure to follow whoever you meet. LinkedIn is all about networking. You should have your connections, and you should have your online presence. You should answer, keep commenting, keep liking, reaching out to new directions. That is how an MBA works. You have to make your connections. You have to indulge with your seniors, your mentors, your faculty members, the sessions you attend throughout your MBA, and everything. You have to do that. That's the main thing that drives your MBA. So that should be done, and work the network nicely. And don't be passive about it. Engage thoughtfully by commenting on articles and joining conversation that you have knowledge about, that you want to learn about. LinkedIn is a very stable and very well-cultured place, if you will say. There is no Reddit on it. You don't have to disagree on without any context. If you are disagreeing, that will be a topic that will be taken to chats most probably, and you will have a nice conversation about it if the person you are chatting with is comfortable. That you should do, but not on the comment sections, and don't go boasting about everything or roasting anybody. That is not LinkedIn. So next is follow your preferred school and its alumni. So I have written school and alumni, considering that you are an MBA person. But if not, then your industry, your past schools, and what your companies that you wish to work for, your dream companies. You can follow everybody and anybody there. You should follow, and then you will get an insight then what is happening there, who all are working, how, if it's hiring, you will be the first person to know. You will get a notification about it, and you can network with the people in that industry. You can ask them questions, how is it like to work there, is there any opportunities there that I can be a part of, take up projects, ask them about it, read up nicely, please. Okay, so this next one is, don't get reckless in your quest for a stronger presence. So we all try, means LinkedIn is quite slow, if we can say, about networking. So not every professional wants anybody coming to your circle, means immediate circle. Not every, you can message the most prominent leaders and you will not find a reply. I am just plain and simple, sometimes you will not get a reply, and that you shouldn't get reckless about it. You should wait, you should approach them on an individual basis and keep it professional and appropriate. Focus on what it is about the person that makes you want to forge a connection with them, and just share that. Give them a chat, give them a nice write-up about what have caught your eye and why are you interested in connecting with them. And then you can, then he will or she will want to connect with you, and the networking will grow as well. So that was on my side. Thank you. I hope you will keep your LinkedIn profiles nice. Thank you.